Fujiyama. I'm Yuki Honda from the Research Center for Electron Science, Tohoku University. So I'd like to talk about the screen potential in liquid metal for the interaction. And our unique measurement method by means of the neutron molecular mean. So the method is already reported by the Professor Basaki in ICCF-20. But we improved the experimental setup and the calculation. And now I got the latest result for the first of all, let me explain the screen effect to the GD reaction. So the cross-section for a nuclear reaction of 20 low energies is governed by the atomic probability for a probability of the chrome barrier. So when the chrome barrier is reduced by electrons, the cross-section is enhanced. This effect is called screen effect. The decrement value of the screen potential is called the screen the decrement value of the chrome barrier is called the screen potential. So denoted as this US. This figure shows the enhancement factor of the DD reaction with the each screen potential. Since the tonic probability has a strong dependence on the energy, so the enhancement factor increases as the energy decreases. Up to the present, screen effect in metal, screen potential in various metals have been reported. So in the metallic electron environment, conduction electron causes the screen effect. However, for some metals, anomalously large screen potential are reported. For example, the reported value by Yuki et al. 310 volts for palladium and 600 volts for palladium oxide. So this figure shows the thermonuclear reaction rate at room temperature with the described as the screen potential. So in this calculation, we suppose the neutron density in metal as 10 to 20 seconds per centimeter. So in such a condition, 610 volts is enough large, and 2500 pounds per centimeter set of the reaction is expected. So like this, large screen potential could occur the photo fusion. So the studying of the screen potential in metal is very important. So another experimental group also reported the large screen potentials. However, there are inconsistencies between the reported values. So this figure shows a part of the reported screen potentials. For example, aluminium and iron and palladium and all. The reported value for these metals greatly differ exceeding the error. So it's pointed out that there should be large systematic errors. So this figure shows the experimental method of the previous solid metal experiment. When the solid metal bombarded by the neutron beam, these deuterons will stop and accumulate at the surface of the metal. So these deuterons are used for the target deuterons. So such a technique was used. The target deuteron density is affected by various factors. So it's difficult to know the precise target deuteron density. So now we introduce a new reaction mechanism which can remove such uncertainties. We use such a mechanism for present experiments. So we call it cooperative collaborative mechanism, CCM. CCM is unique to the molecular beam, and the reaction proceeds by two steps. This figure shows the systematic configuration of CCM. First, one deuteron in a molecular beam is elastically scattered by a metal atom. Second, scattered neutron collide with the other neutron in the same molecule to cause the DT reaction. So estimation of CCME is the initial reactive position. So initial reactive position of the neutrons and cross-section of the clone scattering have been clone scattering is needed. But these values are already known, so the reaction yield can be calculated. So next, I talk about the calculation of the CCM yield. To estimate the CCM yield, we use the two assumptions. So first, before the beam neutron scattered by the metal, beam neutron have the same momentum and they keep the molecular ion formation. So this means that the as the initial state, neutrons have the same energy and going to the same direction and distance is fixed. Second, instead of neutron scattered by the metal nuclei under the screen Coulomb potential. This means that the metal nuclei also have also screened by the conduction electron and boundary electrons. So we use the screen, Bohr screen model. This figure shows the calibrated differential cross section, described as the scattering function of the scattering angle. So this red line shows the calculated cross section of the Bohr screen. And this black line shows the calculated by Turing. So Turing calculation is in good agreement with the, our calculation. Calculation proceeds as follows. First, the trajectory of the instant neutrons are calculated by Monte Carlo simulation. In this calculation, all of the incident neutrons start from the same position. So second, for the DC plus B, we choose the three trajectories and find the time when the distance between the two neutrons correspond to the distance of these three pairs. So finally, we shift the initial position of one of the pair neutrons as a result. The initial position of the neutrons keep the this first assumption and the neutron collided out here. So probability of this reaction obtained by this equation. Next we talk about the experiment. Experimental setup is briefly illustrated in this figure. So we bombarded the lectinium and lead metal with this plasma beam. Lead and lead so placed up here and required by heater. So emitted charged particles from the reaction detected by two silicon detectors. This setup is almost same as the previous salt metal experiment, but we use the lithium metal instead of the salt metal. By the atomic beam measurement, it was verified that the accumulated neutron in the lithium metal is very, very low. So the estimated neutron density for the lithium lead metal 1,000 lower than the, that for the salt metal, So with the liquid metal, we can suppress the normal DD event and observe on this issue again. Next is the improvement experiment. So in the present experiment, we determine the solid angle of the detector by a counting rate of alpha particle emitted from a jetting source. It removed the normalized parameter of the beam. However, in a series of our liquid metal experiments, the solid angle has run dependent. So that gun-dependent is caused by the cleaning of the distributed metal surface by the scraper. In the previous experiment, we considered it as the systematic errors. It was estimated as about 7%. But we measured the surface shape of the electron meter with the laser displacement meter and collected non-dependent fluctuation. This is the result of the experiment. Left figure shows the energy spectra of emitted particles, helium 3 and proton and protons. This red line shows the calculated result based on the CCN. Right figure shows the yield of the proton and protons. This upper marker shows the yield for the red, and lower marker shows the yield for injury. And these black lines show the calculation results. So the experimental results have a good agreement with the calculation. So we deduced the screen potential from the experimental results. So this figure shows the experimental enhancement factor. This is for the regime and this for the head. We fitted these values with the calculated enhancement factor and the reduced screen potential. So that value is 228 volt for Injun and 298 volt for red. This value is smaller than the reported value by the IORA, but greatly larger than the calculated value based on the atmospheric model. As I know my talk, I'd like to discuss about a simple question. So, does the CCM affect the cross-section for the solid metal experiment with the molecular beam? So, left figure shows a simple simulation of the yield for the DT reaction with the DC plus beam. Black line shows the yield of the DT reaction, normal DT reaction. When we use the DC plus beam, the additional contribution from the CCM is black line exists. So the actual experimental yield should be this red line, as a red line. So if we don't have knowledge of CCM, experimental enhancement factor should be described by this equation. So when we consider all the enhancement are caused by screening effect. So the result of fitting is this red and black lines. That's the condition of this. So even though there is no screening effect, so we misunderstand the screen potential is very large. So when molecular beam is used, CCM should be considered. This is summary. So thank you for your attention.
Question time, and we have 1 minute 24 seconds.